So if I said rock, what would you do with your hand? Rock, paper, and what do scissors look like? Scissors, right. So, how does the game work? Who wants to do it with me? Here, Melissa, come do it with me. Okay, so we start out, we say 1, 2, 3, right? Ready? 1, 2, 3, go. She knows how it works. Okay. So, rock beats what? Rock beats scissors. What does paper beat? Paper beats rock, right. What does scissors beat? Charlie? Paper. That's how it works. Exactly. Do you know there's an international tournament that goes, people come from all over the world to a rock, paper, scissors contest? This year it was held in Las Vegas. Adults and children, you should watch the video, it's hilarious. Of them going up there, these adults doing rock, paper, scissors really fast, and then they're out. And then the next one comes in. It's a crazy thing. Okay, so if I had a paper would be good for writing a letter, wouldn't it? Would scissors or a rock be good for writing a letter on? Yes. No. Okay. So if I wanted to cut the paper, would it be better to use the scissors or the rock? The scissors. And if I wanted something to drink, what would be the best? The paper, the scissors, or the rock? If I want something to drink. None, you think? Well, surprisingly, the rock is my choice, and you're going to hear now of why the rock is my choice. Moses was an amazing man. He was amazing, and everywhere he went in our stories, Moses had his staff. He had his shepherd's tool that he used to guide the sheep around. It's not very exciting, nothing big or famous or magical, just a stick. But over the time, some amazing things were done with this staff that Moses had. He turned it into a snake by the burning bush. Well, God did. Moses didn't. He was able to part the Red Sea and move the Israelites across with God's help, with the snake. And today in our story, as you heard Jenny reading, the Israelites are still on their journey. So far, they've been hungry, they're tired. Have you ever had to walk a long way? Like maybe, yeah. A long way on a hike, or a long way.
In Korea.
A long walk in Korea. Okay, did you have a staff when you were walking?
No.
Okay, so you could. So you know how it is. So now they're walking, and now they've gotten some food. They're a little bit closer, but now they are thirsty. And they were grumbling and crabbing. Let me hear your best grumbling and crabbing. It was a lot. Exactly. They were all doing that to Moses. And Charlie, Moses didn't know what to do. So he did what he has always done because he trusted in God. He went to God and he said, "What should I do?" And God said, "You need to go to the special place where there is this special rock." Now imagine this is much bigger. The special rock, and you are going to strike it with your staff, because once again it's going to come through, and water is going to gush out of that rock. And how is it possible? Because with God, anything is possible. Anything. God can do anything. So he brings all the people there, and he strikes the rock with the staff, and guess what happens? What do you think happened?
Water goes out and flood happens.
Well, no flood, but water didn't pour out. Flooding is a whole other story. Today is not flooding. Today is just enough water to drink and to make the people happy. And to keep them going. So I want you to think about the staff today. I want you to think about, for a second, I want you to think about how, and front of our face of what is the answer that God's trying to tell us. Sometimes we're looking for an answer when things aren't going well, and we think it's something really hard and complicated, and we're going to have to search it out, but sometimes it's right in front of us. Because God provides for us. Just like Natalia said, how could that happen? Because God, with God on our side, we can do anything. Let us pray. Dear God, help us to be aware that you are with us. You are right there beside there, us. You are providing us the answer if only we open our eyes and look. You are our